观众朋友们，晚上好，我是阿老师或者阿波罗老师。Good evening, everyone. My name is Apollo, and welcome to 我们说汉语 Let's talk Chinese with.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Wang Xiaojuan. I hope you still remember how to pronounce my name. Even it's a little bit difficult. It's Wang Xiaojuan. Okay, we are from Confucius Institute at Macquarie University. This is already the 18th episode of our show, and we already got a list of winners from those episodes. And of course, today we're gonna meet some new ones.
Amazing, okay. Wonderful. Yeah. Let's continue.
Let's start with the one who called us last week. Mm-hmm. This is
Rogers.
The question was, how do you say they? How do you say they? The answer should be 他们. Okay, I remember Rogers is
yes,
from
Rogers, Mbarara. Rogers
yeah, Mbarara. It's a far
we
place.
We had other callers from Jinja. We had callers from Kampala, Munyonyo. And also, we had callers from several parts of the country. That's very good. Our show is reaching very wide, so don't be left behind.
Okay, then we go back to question number two. What is radical of men?
Men.
And why? This one was on Facebook. I think
he's called Turiahawe Edwins.
Okay,
Turiahawe Edwins.
Congratulations, you are one of our winners from last week. The question, the answer is, it's radical means person and final, which means door is for the pronunciation. Yeah, it's here. And he also wrote something on a piece of paper. It's not very clear, but from my perspective, I think it's correct. The radical means person. The next part, it's pronounced men. Door. It's for the pronunciation. So
Wonderful.
We get a perfect well-structured character, as you can see on the paper. Then we have the third one.
Jim.
How do you say Jim? How do you write Jim in characters? And we have
健身房.
Yes, 健身房. We have. I selected two. The first one is from
Stephen Bin Jude Fortunate. He has never answered before. Stephen Bin Jude on Twitter.
That's why the winner is this one, not this one, because Isaka, I think.
Yes, Isaka at Norman Tweets.
The answer is also correct. 健身房, 健身房, gym, gym. Of course, these characters are a little bit complicated, but as Stephen did, you also can practice writing on your paper, and which helps a lot with learning the characters and the grammatical points. Of course, you can use all of these characters to make sentences. Okay, those are the three winners from last week. Congratulations, everyone. You will have a chance to attend the final function where you also have a chance to be selected as one of the five top winners fully sponsored to go to China.
And for those of you who've been wondering whether you can answer these questions, our Facebook pages on Twitter and Facebook page and Twitter handles are open for you to join and sign up. For example, Urban TV at Facebook and Urban TV Twitter, so you can be able to answer the questions. We normally post them after the show.
Yes, and but we are already announcing the questions now.
Yes.
You will see them on Facebook, Twitter later. The first question is, how do you say
good morning?
Please call us and answer this question. I think good morning is something you can use daily, which is very practical for you to study. Question number two, what is the radical of ka and why?
Ka.
This one will be on Facebook. Question number three, please write this character. It's pronounced shang.
Shang.
Yeah, these are the three questions, and please remember to call us to answer the first one.
Yes, and the number to call is 0414, get a piece of paper, 0414 337 872-0414-337-872. All right, that's the number to call. You can always call in later when our lines are open for you.
Okay, we'll expect your calls. While we're doing that, let's review something from last week. Hmm. The characters we studied last week.
Yes.
The first one, men.
Men.
It's a particle, you can use it after the words like ta, wo, to indicate person. Mm-hmm. If you use men after them, it'll be like 他们, they.
他们.
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 They. 我们.
我们. 我们.
We. 医院. 医院.
医院.
Hospital. 宿舍.
宿舍.
宿舍. Dorm. 公园.
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 Park. 银行.
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 Bank. 健身房.
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 Gym. Okay, we will have to stress something about the character we studied last time.
All right.
Which is, I don't know if it's difficult for you guys. I don't think it is, because you already studied a lot of characters which are very easy to remember. This one, even it has two parts, it's still easy.
Very
to
easy.
Practice. Why? Because these two parts, as you can see on the screen, the first part, it's the radical, which indicates the meaning. This one, for this one, the radical is person. It's from this character person, which we studied before.
Person?
It goes like this when it works as a radical. It indicates the meaning of plural. So you add it with other words like I, he, she, 我, 他, to say something like 他们,
okay.
They, 我们, we. And the second part, this part, it's pronounced men, which means door. Apparently, it's for the pronunciation, because as you can see from the pronunciation from the PN,
men.
Yeah, similar pronunciation. So this is also an easy character for you to practice and for you to memorize. I think you already memorized it because you already explained twice and it's been a week. I hope you were practicing during the week.
All right. You have enough time to practice.
Yes. So it's time for us to practice some sentences. 你喜欢做什么?
我喜欢打乒乓球。你们的爱好是什么?
我们喜欢在健身房跑步。你呢?
我喜欢在公园打篮球。
Okay, the first part, 你喜欢做什么? You like doing what? You like doing what? 我喜欢打乒乓球。 I like playing ping pong. 你们的爱好是什么?
Very good.
Your hobbies are what?
你们的爱好是什么?
We studied all of this before. 我们喜欢在健身房跑步。
你呢?
We like in the gym running.
Running.
So the point here is you have to put the place 在健身房, in a gym, before
跑步,
run, running. You have to put it before the verb. 你呢? What about you? 我喜欢在公园打篮球. It's the same. It's the same. I like in the park playing basketball.
我喜欢在公园打篮球.
Okay. Those are the sentences we studied last time. So we will remind you of the questions again. Number one, how do you say good morning? Please call us. Number two, what is the radical of ka and why? It's it's on Facebook. Mm. Number three, please write Shang. This one will be on Twitter.
All right.
Then, of course, we are going to study something new, especially the pronunciation part.
Yes.
We haven't studied any of the new pinyin in weeks, but
mm-hmm.
today we have two more. We have two, as you can see, they're with stars here. The first one is pronounced fu. It's similar to some words like fire, fine.
Mm.
So it's very easy. Next one,
ts. It's like
a
ts.
Yeah, it's like ts.
Mm.
For example, that's.
Mm. Yeah, that's. Yeah, that's true.
So, yeah.
Mm. And it appears in words like cai.
Yes.
Chungguo cai.
Cai means dish.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm.
Just remember ts. How do you pronounce ts if they're together in English?
Mm.
Okay, these are two initials in Chinese pinyin, and we are going to use them with tonal marks, different tonal marks. As you can see here, we have several characters with different tones. The first group is there with the first tone, the flat tone. Zhong.
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 It's flat.
Can. Can.
Can.
Can.
Can.
Can.
Ka.
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 Fei.
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 Ting.
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 We don't have the second tone today, but we have three, the third tones. Yo.
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 Wu.
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 Zao.
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 Okay, the last one, the fourth tone, is a rising tone. It's a falling tone.
Mm.
The second tone is the rising tone.
Yeah.
Shang.
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 Okay. Then we'll have to use those characters to form some phrases. For example, these ones. The first one is a character Shang.
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 Which means up.
Yes.
The upper side. The upper side. Zao Shang.
Zao Shang.
Zao Shang.
Zao Shang.
Morning.
Mm.
中午,
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 noon, 早餐,
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 breakfast. Of course, 早 means morning.
Morning, yes.
Yes, 早上, the duration of the time, morning. 早餐, breakfast. 午餐,
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 lunch, 咖啡,
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 coffee. Well, for this one, this character, it is in a question, but we will not explain as we explain other characters. Here, please pay attention. As you can see, the character is with a very familiar radical, which is
口字旁,
yes, which is the mouth.
Yes.
口, the mouth. We study many characters with the same radical before. For example, 喝, drink. 喝. This one is with the radical of 口,
口,
mouth. Why? Because coffee is something you can
drink.
You can drink.
My favorite.
Your favorite.
Yes.
Yes.
I drink a lot of coffee. 我喜欢喝咖啡.
Yeah, 我也喜欢喝咖啡.
Yeah.
My favorite actually is African coffee, especially
Arabic
Uganda
coffee.
One.
I love your coffee.
So, I think it's already clear that you have the answer to answer the question from our Facebook. Ka has the radical of mouth, of course, to indicate you drink coffee with your
mouth.
Next one, 餐厅 restaurant
有
have for example I have coffee
我有咖啡
yes 我 subject
我,
I
我
有 have
有
coffee 我有咖啡 exactly the same grammatical sequence both in Chinese and in English
wow.
So that's why for you it's a lot easier to study Chinese because you can relate
with English
yes of course we have one more new character for today
Shang
please look at this picture first
okay
this is a platform a platform you can think this one as this stroke the lower stroke then this is like this stroke
that is shu right
yes and the flag here it's like this stroke this is a flag and a flag of course is up here
yes.
not lower at the lower place so you can relate this picture picture to this character which means up
okay.
up the flag is up here and the strokes are also similar so please just remember this picture and then you practice writing the character shang yeah it's easy right
yes.
okay we have three strokes from up to down the first stroke is shu shu this one then heng the short heng then the last one the longer heng
okay
yeah so it goes like this shu heng heng
okay
yeah you can just practice writing with your finger
in the air
yeah of course also you can practice with a piece of paper
yes.
and a pen shu heng heng yeah it's easy okay it's time for us to do some sentences
okay
we studied morning right morning is 早上 then if it's good morning 早上好我想买早餐你们有包子吗我们有包子包子五千先令有咖啡吗 多少钱?
有咖啡六千先令好谢谢 we can try one more time
早上好我想买早餐你们有包子吗 我们有包子包子五千先令
有咖啡吗? 多少钱?
有咖啡 6,000先令
好,谢谢
Okay, we start from here 早上好, good morning Remember, you should put good after 早上
Okay
早上好 Then 我想买早餐 早餐 breakfast I want to buy breakfast we studied these three
我想,
characters before
我想买早餐
你们有包子吗?
你们有包子吗?
You have 包子 It's steamed stuffed bun and with 吗 ma, it's a particle to the question which requires the answer of yes or no apparently here do you have steamed stuffed bun 你们有包子吗?
你们有包子吗?
我们有包子。 We have 包子。包子五千先令。包子五千先令。 Baozi with the price, with the price, 5,000 xianling shili. I hope you still remember from number 1 to 10. Yi,
二, 三,
四,
五,
六,
七,
八,
九,
十,
十.
Yeah, 十, it's like this.
Yes.
有咖啡吗？多少钱？有咖啡吗？多少钱？有咖啡吗？ Here we don't have a subject. But it's apparent. It's very obvious the subject should be 你们. Similar to this one.
Yeah.
你们有咖啡吗？ Do you have coffee? 多少钱? How much? 有咖啡六千先令. We have coffee and
六千,
it's 六千先令. 6,000 shillings.
Yes.
好,谢谢. These are all of the sentences. I think the most important ones are you have to know how to use 有.
有.
Have. It's a verb. You use it as how you use other verbs like 买, 买. Bye. And 早上好, good morning, 早上好. It's not 好, 早上, it's 早上好.
Okay. There are those who have shortcuts, they say 有没有包子?
Yeah, okay. Of course, that's more complicated. Yeah. One.
Yes, for the advanced ones.
Yeah, huh? Don't worry, you will study, someday you'll get there.
Oh, okay. 有没有?
Yes. Then the questions again. Number one, how do you say good morning? Of course, it's very easy to answer what is good morning. It's not 好早上, it's something else. Number two, what is the radical of ka and why? We already explained. You can relate ka to the character 喝, drink. Drink. Please write 上. 上, the character you just have to remember the strokes and stroke sequences, or you just copy from here.
Yes. Please write Shang on a piece of paper and post it on our on our Twitter handles. The number to call is 0414-337-872. 0414-337-872. That's the number to call.
Okay, before we move to next step, please enjoy a clip as you roll. Where you can see how the students are doing a conversation with the sentences we studied.
早上好。早上好，我想买早餐，你们有包子吗？我没有，包子，包子五千先令。有咖啡吗？多少钱？有咖啡。
六千先令。好，谢谢。你们有包子吗？我们有包子。包子多少钱？五千先令。好，五千先令。 That's very good. And now let's look at 包子, prepared, delicious, 好吃.
Yes, this is how it looks like. It's like a wrapping, but we have different kinds of stuff inside, fillings. We have, for example, beef, chicken, or vegetables. It's very tasty. I'm sure, Apollo, you had it as breakfast in
very
China.
Very often, while I was at university in China, we used to have that for breakfast. It's the quickest thing you can get on the street in the shitang, in the school canteen, cafeteria. It's very tasty.
Yes. Of course, you also can go to some Chinese restaurants here in Kampala. They all have it. You can ask for different kinds of flavors. Just give it a try. I think you'll love it.
As you're pondering about selecting or choosing which kind of baozi you would like to eat or stuffed buns, Let's have the callers. The lines are open, 0414-337-872. Let's continue.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, speaking of the clips we just watched, do you still remember the girl in the clip?
I think I do.
Yeah, that's the one. Ah. Which one? That's the champion of our competition back.
No wonder the pronunciation was so nice.
Yes,
I was
of
like,
course.
This pronunciation is really nice. She's talented in Chinese language.
She's yeah, she's only a, I think it, she's a high school student.
Ah,
yeah,
yes.
And she's going to China to represent Uganda to compete with other winners from Chinese bridge competition from all of the other countries like Australia, Canada, the United States, UK, some countries like that. And we hope she'll get some
Indeed,
special experience, at, of course, win the competition.
That is good. Chinese Bridge Competition is one of those competitions co-sponsored by the Chinese Embassy and Confucius Institute to promote Chinese culture and language, and many of our students have benefited. Many of them are currently in China studying, some on scholarship, some on short-term scholarships, and some on full scholarships. So learning the Chinese language always opens up so many doors and opportunities. Personally, I always enjoy that every time I get a chance to travel to China.
Yes, and I think it's time for us to.
Yes, and as you're talking of that, the lines are open, 0414-337-872. The lines are still open, 0414-337-872. Please call in and answer the question. How do you say?
Good morning. Of course, it's not good morning. It's also not 好早上. It's something like 模拟早上, good. 好早上好. And question number two, what is the radical of ka and why? The radical is this part, which means the mouth. Because coffee is something you drink. Number three, please write shang. It's on Twitter. The character is very easy, only with three strokes. The first stroke, shu. The second stroke, heng. The third stroke, heng. These are all of the strokes. It's very easy for you to practice writing. I hope you can get a piece of paper and a pen and practice writing while you're now with us watching our show. And I think you'll memorize it when you have a chance, have a time to leave your comment below our page.
Okay.
Let's practice some sentences
one
again.
One more time.
早上好。早上好，我想买早餐。你们有包子吗？ 我们有包子，包子5000先令。有咖啡吗？多少钱？ 有咖啡6000先令。好。
谢谢.
Yeah, here, except 包子, 包子, we have something else which looks similar to 包子, but without the filling.
No, okay.
It's not stuffed. It's just something like a bread, but it's plain, not sweet, not salty. We call it
馒头.
Yeah, of course, 馒头. 馒头.
馒头.
Especially for northern Chinese people,
yes,
for example,
yes.
Me, I'm from northwestern China. That's our daily breakfast. We all love it, and it's very easy to make, and it's very convenient to restore.
Yeah, she's talking about mantou. It's
yeah.
also very easy to make if you have a rice cooker at home. Just you can Google on YouTube, and you can be able to find out how to make it. It's very easy. I've ever made it at home. It's very tasty. And talking of that, thank you so much for being wonderful viewers on Urban TV. And remember to follow my Twitter handle at Namisi Moses Apollo, and also on Facebook, same name, Namisi Moses Apollo. And also remember to follow us, Urban TV, Facebook and Twitter, and we would like to thank you for following the Chinese Embassy in Uganda on Twitter. We are very glad that you keep learning and following Chinese language here. Let's Talk Chinese on Urban. We always thank you, and we're always happy to have you as our audience. Want to thank you and wish you a good night. 晚安。
再见。